Well, President Barzani, thank you so much for joining us. This is the first time that you have spoken publicly since President Obama outlined his strategy to destroy ISIS. A lot is being asked of you and your Peshmerga forces. What do you think of the President's plan?
The threat of ISIS is not only against the Kurdish people in Kurdistan. It's a threat for the whole world. It's a threat that it's affecting everyone. So we are supporting President Obama's strategy, and we do hope that it's going to have results and also to expand the strategy to include the others.
Now, it's the Peshmerga who are the boots on the ground here in northern Iraq. Do you feel that your forces are ready for this fight against ISIS?
I think Peshmerga is proof that they are capable. It's true that from the first days of the assaults of the ISIS that Peshmerga had some loss, but after the securing the airstrikes, Peshmerga managed to control the areas to stop the expansions and the offensive of the ISIS, and also by driving them out from the areas, and the Peshmerga has proved that they have been successful in that. So we do believe that Peshmerga right now, they have initiative and they are on the offensive.
Are you prepared to go outside your borders of Kurdistan, let's say Mosul, and fight there?
Our top priority is to protect our borders and the peoples with the different components of the Kurdistani society, with all the minorities that we have here. But if there will be a comprehensive strategy and a comprehensive program with the Iraqi federal government and our allies, so wherever we can, we will support any kinds of the programs against them.
Tell me, how effective have the US airstrikes been, considering they have been quite limited in their scope?
I can say that the airstrikes have been very, very effective, and it has a lot of impact on the situation, and they managed to inflict a lot of harms and pains to the enemy. And these airstrikes, they have been very, very precise, no collateral damages, no civilians have been hurt anywhere, and there is a great level of cooperation between our forces and the American forces.
There have been some countries that have offered to send in ground forces. Do you envisage that happening in the future?
We have not asked for the ground forces from any countries, but any country in which way they prefer to participate, to take part in the fight against ISIS, whether through sending ground forces or through airstrikes or through sending ammunition, we welcome any kind of these decisions and participation.
Now, a global coalition is being formed against ISIS that includes some regional partners. One of the countries that has been excluded, however, is Iran. Tell me the role that Iran could play if they were involved.
I think that the Iranian role should not be disregarded, and I do believe that if they have participated, it would have been better because of the role of Iran. And they have not participated because of some other problems that they have between each other. That's something different.
So what would be your appeal to the United States, to Iran, on this particular matter?
My message to them that they should put aside whatever their differences is, that's left for them, what are the problems and the differences between Iran and the United States. But I do believe that my message, my appeal to them is that to put aside their differences in fighting ISIS and do not mix ISIS, fighting ISIS with their ongoing problems.